Okay, we are finished with the setup. Let's get the aircraft ready for push and start. Performance, flaps 1. V1 133, VR 134, V2 138. Okay. So let's push back underway. Push back. Start.
Cockpit to ground.
This is ground. Stand by.
Let's roll up our short. Gate is pulling away. Beautiful sunrise departure.
Okay, sir. The bypass pin is installed. All doors and hatches closed and all ground equipment is removed.
The parking brakes are set. You may lift.
Parking brake set. Lifting the aircraft. Standing by for pushback.
Rookie mistake. I forgot to turn on the ABU. Smaller strobes to go to and turn off the dome lights. Sun is coming up. ABU is pulling. Now we are ready to push. Once we release our parking brake.
Cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
We are cleared for start and push. Parking brake set.
Okay, cleared for push start. Please release parking brake.
Parking brakes are released.
Commencing pushback. You can start the engines in sequence.
It will start in the sequence.
Starting engine 2. Beautiful sunrise. Start our first engine. So engine 2 stabilized, engine 1 starting. Let's get our passenger signs on.
Okay, pushback completed. Please set your parking brake.
Parking brake set.
Parking brake set. Lowering aircraft.
Ground. Startup is complete. You may disconnect.
We should Roger. Taxi good engine start. Clear to disconnect.
Victor
see you at the side.
Have a good
flight.
Holding position, waiting for the visual. Thank you and goodbye.
Victor 2 is in India. We will depart from Golf 2. Most engines are stabilized. Engine start switch to normal. Speed brake armed. Flaps to 1.
Comic traffic, Scandinavian 828 Bravo, pushing that stand 19, the stand 9 facing south.
ABU off, ABU bleeds off, taxi lights to taxi, runway turn off lights to on. Copenhagen traffic, Lufthansa 458, taxiing to runway 30 via Tango, Victor crossing runway 22 left on Victor 2, India and Golf 2. Let's start our taxi. Let's get our flight controls check. Pull up, pull down. For right, for left, rudder for right, for left, and brakes check completed, let's get our takeoff, start our clock, and get our takeoff config, once we get near the runway, currently on Victor, as you can see from the charts on our top left screen. Continue into Victor, then cross runway 22 left on Victor 2. Lufthansa 458, A320 crossing runway 22 left at Victor 2, Copenhagen traffic. Get our landing lights on as we are crossing the runway. And our strobes to on. Let's notify the cabin.
Flight attendants, please prepare for takeoff.
Copenhagen traffic, Lufthansa 458, A320neo will depart runway 30 at Golf 2 intersection.
Copenhagen traffic, Scandinavian 774, we will taxi your holding point runway 22 right via Elf and we hold short for Lufthansa.
Thank you.
Copenhagen traffic, Scandinavian 281, taxi to holding point, runway 22 right by Alpha, and behind the company is Scandinavian, Copenhagen traffic.
Okay, everyone ready? Take off. Copenhagen traffic, Lufthansa 458, E320 departing runway 30. Mantua SRS runway. V1, rotate. Positive rate, 0.
Make traffic, Scandinavian 774, crossing Clio, holding point 222 right.
Throttle to climb.
One
riding thrust. Oh, looks like our wizard bug is back again, so we'll have to turn off the life, was it? So, what happened is Microsoft Flight Simulator have a wizard bug that air temperature rises to 200 degrees, which renders the engine inoperable. So we burned 1 ton of fuel in just a few minutes. Autopilot 1. We have to wait for LNAV to engage to get managed altitude.
Scandinavian 774, departing runway 22 right. Targeting one.
The beautiful city of Copenhagen. Flaps up. Hopefully the nav engages this time. We'll climb directly to flight level 280, which is our final flight level.
Scandinavian 28 Bravo lining up. Right, the big thing.
And we'll have a direct meeting. Clear our power for floodland discontinuity. Discontinuity. Beautiful views. At this time I'll try to turn the life wizard on again and see what happens. Oh, it's still there. So no life wizards for this flight. Only viewer, welcome to the stream, sir. Or ma'am. We are about to cross Nixon, which is last waypoint of our departure, and we'll join November 850 Airway to our destination, and we are about 4,000 feet to reach our cruising altitude. Some icing effect on the window, so I'll turn the window heat on. Try those again. Oh, no, 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 no. So, in this case, I will use those a preset to give our flight some realistic scene. It's really an annoying bug what we have with Oizar currently. Hello, yeah, it's a fly pad. Yeah, it has. When controllers are online, it displays the frequencies, and also you can have your OFB, which is operational floodplain you get from SimPrief, and you can have also charts. I'm using the charts on my other screen, but you can also have Navigraph charts on it. So yeah, it's helpful. You can have Navigraph charts on here. I'm currently not having it active, but yeah, you can use it for navigation also, and communication. This tab is for communication. Currently we have no active controllers, so we have no one here, but I'm currently flying on Vaxim, but it's early morning, no controllers are online, but you will have them here when they are available. Here is a OFB charts PDF, so you can navigate. Here is our weights, so you can drag it with your mouse. That's cool. So that's our operational flight plan, and you can have it here also. So if you are flying VR, it will be really helpful. Don't have to look outside. Yeah, it's fly-by-wire aircraft. You can check a website, just search on Google fly-by-wire Airbus for Microsoft Flight Simulator. You will have a website, and you can download the installer from there. Unfortunately, we have the user bug back again, so I can't turn on the live weather. I'm currently flying with a weather preset. It looks cool, but live weather would be much better. So if you like our stream, follow, don't forget to follow, it helps a lot. Yeah, as soon as I took off, my engines like rendered useless immediately. I didn't have any power, so I was confused a bit, but then I looked at the temperature here, it was 270 something, so I turned it off immediately. Yeah, even in takeoff now, you can't take off with life weather. It's I hope they issue a fix immediately, or as soon as they can. Yeah, so now we are approaching our turn of descent, so we will set up our arrival. We have November India Echo 27 arrival for runway 27, so ILS 27, then November India Echo 27 arrival. The Echo transition. Cert. So think it's runway 9. And the transition. Let's review our chart. Land on runway 27 to close the right, so we are this bend. And minimums are 50 for Cat 3 RR. So after the next turn, we'll start our descent. He told you vector 186 turner H. Yeah, he's telling you your route. So vector 186 means your airway, then Tanner, that's a waypoint or VR, and HDF and pits, that's your he's telling you your route. Either it was a rerouting or he was rereading your route with you. VATSIM is a great learning experience. If you give it time, you will get the hang of it. Also, there is a lot of YouTube tutorials and videos that explains it. So if you spend some time, and also you can watch real world videos over just planes, for example, and pilot's eye, and airclips.com. You'll find all of that on YouTube. So it will help you a lot. Just get used to the physiology and get used to hearing pilots and air traffic control speaking to each other. It will help you a lot. Also, this aircraft doesn't have a VNAV yet, so it makes a lot of sharp turns. Now we have flight plan is coming. So I'll proceed direct to Charlie Hayden. That will get us to base, to runway. Set up our performance data as it should be, but hopefully I can get a meter from the sim. So the pressure is 1013 and temperature is 15. Temperature is 15. And wind calm, and our minimums are 50. Radio altimeter. Actually, I'm gonna use a CAT2. So So our missing approach procedures are climb straight ahead passing 600, turn right max 185 knots, climb max 3000 feet. So our turn, our go around altitude is 3000 feet. Over traffic, Lufthansa 458, Airbus 320, NEO inbound for ILS runway 27 right. That's Navigraph. You can find the website, it's navigraph.com. It's very similar to 4Flight, but it's for simulation purposes. So it's cheaper, of course, and you can use it directly as a simulator without having to export your GPS coordinates from the simulators and do a lot of workarounds to get it to 4Flight. So Navigraph is your choice if you are looking to get more and more into simulation. continue to 2,000 feet. And let's activate approach phase. Approach phase activated. Let's keep our speed up. Speed brake to arm. Flaps one. Let's deploy our speed brake together to give us a little bit of drag. Okay, let's reduce to our performance speed and runway inside, gear down, let's do. Arm approach. Flaps full. And let's notify the captain.
Flight attendants, please prepare for landing.
Oh, I probably do. Yeah, they did a really great job with aircraft. So, as Lufthansa do it for real life, many hours throttle, and my aircraft, autopilot off. And it's also a free aircraft. Can you imagine? That's the outer marker. The beeping sound. So, our landing checklist. Landing gear down. Speed brakes low. Little bit low on flaps. And cabin ready. Spoilers armed. Flaps full.
500.
Stabilized.
200. 100 above. 100. Minimum.
Landing.
50. 40. 30. 20. 10. 5.
Spoilers deployed. Reverse. Reverse green. Disabled and the auto brakes sometimes don't disable itself, so we have to disable it by manually. Lubricate on kilo and clean up the aircraft. Thank you. Flaps up. Auto brakes. Yeah. It's beautiful. Yeah, beautiful and it's free. Can you imagine? We have this quality of product for absolutely free. Yeah, salute to these guys. Yeah, it is. Also, we have Salty Simulation 747. They are modifying the default 747 for the simulator and Heavy Mode 787. All these amazing people are working for to give us a quality aircraft for free. So, yeah. Also, the pushback add-on is free and. A lot of stuff. If you go to flightsim.to, you will find a lot of free stuff for Microsoft Flight Simulator. Yeah, I think its name, I forgot its name, but it's Pushback Helper or something. If you go to flightsim.to, you can find it and look for Pushback, there you can find it. Yeah. where is our terminal? Get to gate number 2 Alpha. Square up the APU. And if you bleed, external power is already available. We can turn off our engines and get the gates connected. Gates is not working. So exactly as I saw, broken scenery, Microsoft, broken scenery. So, where should we go next? Frankfurt? Maybe. Oh, Mr. Hickintabatu, thank you very much for watching and for chatting with me along the way. It was really nice to meet you. That's it for this morning, and I hope I will see you again next on our next stream. You're welcome. You're welcome, and if you have any questions, Make sure, don't hesitate to contact me. Yeah, yeah, of course, you can find me on Discord or you can find me on Discord. I will try to contact you. I'm still new to Twitch, so there is no subscription button for me. Hopefully it will come soon. I have sent you my my Discord username, so if you need any help with flying or with Batsim, just send me a message. You're welcome anytime.